Hey guys, I'm Alex. Welcome to another tutorial of After Effects. Today I'm gonna show you how to render your project 500 times faster than your normal render time. I'm going to show you three tricks. You can also use it as a combination of either of the one, but I haven't tried any of them. I've tried with the combination of the first two, and the third one is optional. If you want it, you can use it all together. So let's hop on to our After Effects. This is the video that we did last, which is glowing neon sign text in After Effects. The first trick is to hold the shift button on your keyboard, and while holding the shift key on the keyboard, go to edit and go to preferences, go to general. Now release the shift key on the keyboard. As you guys can see, there is a secret tab over here. This secret tab doesn't pop up if you are not holding the shift key properly. So let's click on secret. Now check both of these boxes and set the purge to 2. Hit enter. Now it's all set. This will bring down your render time to the least. The second step is again to go to the edit, preferences and general. We could have done it in the last step, but just to show it as a different step, you know. Nightmare. So as you guys can see, I wasn't holding the shift key right now. I can't see the secret tabs. You can check it out for yourself on your Adobe After Effects. Go to memory and multiprocessing. Here you can adjust the amount of RAM that the computer uses. Now currently it uses 0.8 for me. I'm gonna leave it at that because I like it that way. I just hit enter. So these are my settings. For you, you can always change it. If you have a 16 GB RAM, then definitely go for up to 10 or maybe 12 as you like it. This will speed up the rendering time and you don't have to wait too much on that. Also, you have to check in the render multiple frames simultaneously. These recommended settings will usually speed up the entire render process. But if you want it to be the fastest, then you can adjust the RAM. That is, you have to increase the RAM so that the process gets finished quickly. You can click on OK. Now the third tip is to hit the caps lock button on your keyboard. Just hit it, do not press and hold it. Once you have hit caps lock key, go to composition and click on render queue or Adobe encoder, whichever you have. So what happens when you hit caps lock is that it will freeze the entire live screen over here. So when you're rendering, this screen won't show you the real-time playback of the video. So it saves a ton of rendering time. Now I have my render queue over here. Click on the best settings. These are my personal settings, but I would recommend going with it as it does help in my render time. Quality best. Resolution full, definitely, and my preferred size is 1920 by 1080, which gives me a HD quality. Usually I like to go it with 30 frames per second. You can also go with 60. Click OK, then go to lossless. In the format, instead of AVI, I like it to go it with QuickTime because it does help with the render time again. Make sure the video output is checked, because if it is not, then you won't get a video output. It's a bit obvious. Go to format options. Here in the video codec, make sure that you are selecting H.264 and you can set the quality to 100, but I usually like it at 96 or 97, 98 just to finish it up quickly. Click OK. If you have an audio, make sure you check it as well. I like the audio as 48,000. Hit OK. You can set the output file name here and just hit on render. Just notice the estimate remaining time over here. It's degrading down, as you guys can see. It should be 1 hour and 20 minutes, but it's gonna take me 7 minutes. Oh, let's say 8, since there is the elapsed time. So instead of 1 hour 22 minutes, it's gonna take me just 8 minutes to render this entire clip. I'm gonna stop it. I don't want it because I already have it. I know that was pretty helpful. Let's get this video to 80 likes. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.